Up comes the turn, straight away airborne. Very quick at climbing, very quick at accelerating. Bit of test of the controls there, so she just applies full forward and full aft elevator control. You just see the nose of the aircraft nodding up and down as she's testing the aeroplane. Now an inverted flight check, so up and down, make sure there's no loose articles in the cockpit. Testing her straps are all secure, ready for what are, quite frankly, some very crazy aerobatic manoeuvres. 3,000 feet. Crazy rolls in the extra. Those ailerons I talked about, very big on each end of the wing. The aircraft can actually roll at 400 degrees a second. That's what she was just demonstrating. Here we go again. So rolling towards us. Vertical climb, rolling in the vertical. Slow rolling now, reversing the turn. She's going to position into a flat spin now, so you can see the aircraft is purely flat as she spins back towards the earth, recovers from that, 90 degrees nose down, pitching hard, she pulls out, back onto the display, into a 4-point roll.
How many G's is she pulling at that point?
Oh, probably at the recovery of that vertical dive, maybe around about 6G. The aircraft is actually stressed to plus 10G. Little Ruard at the top there, little tumble. Onto the 45 down. Upside down now. I talked about stress to plus 10G. More alarmingly, the aircraft is actually stressed to minus 10G. So you can push minus 10G in this aircraft. Now this is pulling up into the vertical. Into what we call a knife edge spin. So now on the knife edge, so the wing pointing down as she spins the aircraft back down into the vertical there. Snap there. You see the kink in that smoke because she's pulling very hard, probably around 5G to recover that maneuver. Hesitation roll on the way out, called the B axis, so the crowd front 90.
And how much is it? Nerves, skill, physical
practice,
strength.
Practice and skill, and quite a lot of physical strength. And to the G-force, Melanie's working very hard. So that is a minus seven turn there. I talked about it being stressed to minus 10. So at plus seven, so seven times the force of gravity, everything gets heavier. The blood wants to go out of your head, but you can strain against it. At minus seven, there's nothing you can do to stop that blood rushing to your head. So into a tail slide. That was a torque roll and tail slide.
So is the engine actually cutting out at that point?
No, the engine's probably staying, depending on what she's doing. If some manoeuvres you will use the throttle to help the performance of the aircraft, that gyroscopic properties of the propeller I talked about. So rolling circle now, you can see Melanie's going to perform a 270 degree turn as she rolls the aircraft around its longitudinal axis. Now in on the crowd front 90. For the B axis, upside down, this is going to be a push away. So get around about minus six, minus seven. She pushes into an inverted or an outside half loop, a flick roll at the top, and then keeps climbing as she turns to the right. You can see there that the power of the engine against this very light airframe.
And all this negative and positive G, I mean, what does that do to the body and how tiring is it?
Well, it's very tiring. So the positive G when you're straining against it, trying to stop that blood rushing to your feet and out of your hands. She's working very hard against that positive G. Not all you can do for the negative, just sends all those, you've been on a roller coaster and you get those weird speckles in your eyes after you go over a humpback bridge or a roller coaster. That's exactly what's happening as you push negative G. So stationary flight now, hovering on the propeller. Very little forward speed. Back down onto the vertical and recovering around 6G. I think this might be the freestyle element now. She's climbing up through the vertical for a half loop. slanted as it flies up. But the beauty of the extra, because those control surfaces are so big, and they all sit in the slipstream of that big propeller and that 330 horsepower engine, the spin recovery to recover from any departed flight is very instantaneous. You just almost centralise the controls and tell the aeroplane to stop, and it just does what it tells you. It's a fantastic aeroplane for these type of aerobatics. Smoke probably around about a 7-8 G pull into the vertical. A Lomshavak on the way up, so again departing the aircraft on the way up the hill. Lomshavak meaning hangover in Czech. You can see why the effect that would have on the body, throwing the aircraft around like that. Engine sound cuts,
but it's not cut.
It's not cut though. It's just maybe a reduction in throttle, which just changes the sound of the engine.
And if you wanted to buy one of these extras, you know, how much would you have to have in your current account?
I think an early model you might get for £150,000, perhaps.
Yeah. So when do they first start getting produced?
That is a very good question. I don't have those.
I mean, are they sort of 70s, 80s?
Probably in the 80s for when the first design came for the competition aerobatics, and they've just been developed. The newest version is called the Extra NG, the next generation, or new generation. So coming down the line now, slow roll. So using her hands and feet to slow roll because of the way the aircraft wants to drop. As you roll slowly, you have to use your feet coordinated with your hands. As the aircraft rolls, you use the rudder to keep the fuselage in the position you want it to keep the aircraft level. So a lot of coordination during a slow roll using hands and feet. So we're coming for a knife edge. Now this is a good time for cameras, and get your arms ready, boys and girls. Massive rudder on the trailing edge of the tail, as I mentioned before, in the slipstream of that propeller, so you can get a huge amount of control authority from the rudder, which enables the aircraft to fly a very steep knife edge, almost 90 degrees of flight.
I mean, that is unbelievable skill, isn't it?
As I said before, a lot of practice. So actually, Melanie has been flying for a long time. She's got 4,500 hours. She has 6 French titles to her name and a UK title in varying levels of competition aerobatics. In fact, she was the only female to compete in the Red Bull Air Race. The eagle-eyed amongst you might see under the wings are almost paddles sticking down, connected to those ailerons I talked about for roll control. I'll let Melanie do her next manoeuvre, then explain what they are. You can just see the silhouette of them now underneath. Those are the red panels underneath. Another wave in that knife edge. So those panels, they're called aileron spades. They are connected to the ailerons, and they stick out into the airflow. So if you can picture putting your hand out of a car window on a motorway, if you held your hand perfectly level, it would stay where it was. The second you lift or drop your fingertips, the airflow would push your hand down. That's what's exactly happening with those aileron spades. Connected to the ailerons in the airflow, as soon as you move them away from the horizontal, they get caught by the airflow and give you a very crisp response in your aileron control. So essentially, it's like power steering for the ailerons, which is what gives the aircraft that very rapid, crisp roll rate. And as I said, 400 degrees a second, which is quite phenomenal when you're trying to do a 360 roll and stop exactly wings level.
But Mike, I mean, you're talking about all the skill and how much practice goes into this, but you're still ultimately one person in a single-seater plane. So is it just a case of, okay, I can do this role and let's push a little bit harder and a bit harder and a bit harder? I mean, it seems that to me, as a sort of layman, that would require a huge amount of faith in your growing abilities, and certainly, you know, you have to be careful not to get too cocky. I mean, these planes are still machines, and you know, you stop taking liberties, it all goes wrong, doesn't it?
Absolutely. So in Melanie's case, she started at the sort of grassroots level of competition aerobatics, and then as she became more and more proficient, she went up in the classes, which enabled her to do more and more different manoeuvres that you see during her display. And it's all about just safely developing your own skill and performance to make sure you don't bite off more than you can chew.
So just building up and building up.
Exactly that, very safe, sort of building block approach to getting yourself to the standard that Melanie's done there. Now, she's just touched down, ladies and gentlemen, definitely, I think that was very worthy of a round of applause. Please put your hands together for Melanie Astles in her extra 330 SC.
Well, we're just
by putting your hands together
and show your appreciation in the usual way. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the night. Hope, I'm sure you will.
Thank you very much, Michael, and I echo those sentiments entirely. So, just a reminder, ladies and gentlemen, please do keep hydrated, keep the sunscreen going on. We do have a pair of sunglasses that have been handed in to VIP reception, so if you're missing some sunglasses, please make